Hi, my name is Marcus Huyskens, and in this video, we're going to be taking a look at working with RePitch 2 Elements. So let's dive in. So I'll be working in Pro Tools Ultimate today, which is an ARA compatible DAW, but it's worth mentioning that everything that I'm talking about in this video is going to apply across the board because we're talking about the basics of working with RePitch 2 and pitch correction in general. All right, so let's get started. The very first thing that I'm going to do is we need to get our audio sent over to RePitch 2. Now, depending on which DAW you're working with, there could be a couple different ways to do this, especially ARA DAWs, but in Pro Tools, we have a really quick and easy option to right-click the clip, and then we have an ARA plugins menu where we can choose RePitch. Now, in addition to that, if you head over to the track header and click in this section, we can also load the ARA plugin from within here. Before I start this though, I'm gonna work off of a duplicate playlist in case we wanted to addition the changes against our original. So let's go ahead and let's load our instance of RePitch. Now the minute we load an instance of RePitch, you're gonna see this automatic scale detection. If you know the key of the song that you're working with, and this is correct, you do have the ability to click apply, and then this will actually input the scale in the scale section. In this case though, I'm just going to click the X because we are going to work in chromatic mode. All right, let's talk about basics in terms of navigation. If we click this area in the bottom, we have the ability to scroll from left to right. We can click these drag handles if we want to zoom in on a very specific position of our audio. We can also do the same vertically over here. We can zoom in and out vertically, but I'm going to show you a different way. If we hold the Option Command modifiers or Alt Control on a PC, click, hold down, we're vertically zooming. And if we drag our mouse to the right, we're horizontally zooming. So this is kind of like a dynamic zooming behavior. Now we can pair this with Shift Command or Shift Control on a Mac to click, hold, and drag to reposition. Now in terms of the way that this works in an ARA compatible DAW is that anywhere I click from within the timeline of the actual ARA editor in RePitch, notice this is following in the DAW, and it's the same thing over here. If I click in the actual clip within Pro Tools, that follows within RePitch. There's also some really useful features from within RePitch where if you double click from within the editor,
picture us rolling, picture us on the PCH on the way.
Double click to stop, we can engage playback directly from within the editor. This is when you need to hear something isolated. But if you're working like I am, where you have an instrumental in the background, we can also press play from within the DAW to get our harmonic reference.
Picture us rolling.
All right, so that's the basics in terms of kind of like navigation. Now I want to talk about the main tools. So we have a selector tool in which we have two different modes. We have a center notes tool, we have a split tool, and then we have a warp tool. Let's start off with the main selector tool. Now there's two different modes. We have a multi-edit mode and we have a single mode. Let's start with the multi-edit mode. And I'm going to zoom in on a very specific section over here. Now in the multi-edit mode, if you position your mouse cursor in the top 50% of this pitch block, we have the ability to click, hold, and drag to change our tuning. But if you place your cursor in the bottom corners, either the left corner or the right corner, then we actually have the ability to change the timing of a very specific section. Or, going to use the undo key there, if we select multiple pitch blocks and we move them together, we can move the timing relative to each other.
On the way back from the...
So let's use one more option over here. I'm going to highlight all of these, right-click, and let's choose the option to reset all changes. Now, I'm going to probably be using the single edit mode for the duration of this video, because basically what that means is that anywhere that I click, it's only going to be adjusting the tuning. Now, really quick and easy way to tune if you're using the single edit selection mode is we just simply double click in any of these pitch blocks and we can snap them to the center. And this is, of course, based upon the nearest pitch in terms of where the sung performance was sung. Now, whenever you have these areas like we're seeing over here, where you have a pitch trace that's kind of moving, this is a really great option to use the split tool. And what we can do is we can actually separate these off into different sections. So you can see over here, as I made this split, that it's changing the notes. And I can do the same thing over here, for example. And we can go through, do the same thing here. This is something that I generally like to do, is kind of go through all the different sections and take a look to see if anything should have been separated. Then I'll give this a really quick split. And then this kind of makes life easier for me in terms of my tuning. Let's go back to the beginning over here, and we're going to be working with the single edit mode, and let's explore some of the other options that we have. If you hover your mouse cursor over any pitch block, we have two different macro controls. The first one is drift, And as I click, hold, and drag, we have the ability to kind of straighten out the drift of this pitch trace. That is really useful, especially if you have something that looks like it's tilted. You can tilt it back into a better position. Now, in addition to that, if we hover in the bottom right, we have a correction amount. And as we dial this up to 100%, this is basically the same as if I double-clicked one of these pitch traces to snap things to 100%. Now, if you hover, notice that we have both of those. We have the drift and we have the correction slider. But if you mouse click across a pitch block, we also have one more macro control. And this is really useful if you wanted to either increase or decrease things like vibrato in terms of the modulation. So watch this. If I click, hold, and drag this down, I've just essentially straightened out that vibrato pitch trace.
Just rolling.
Right? And that can be useful sometimes. In addition to that, we can actually increase it if we wanted to make it more drastic. Let's right click again, and we're going to reset that. So what I'll probably do is just use the drift to adjust this, and then we'll use the correction amount, and this should kind of level this into place. Now let's explore using the center notes tool. So I'm going to switch to the center notes tool. Let's click, hold, and drag and kind of zoom something into view. If I select across these blocks over here and I use the correction slider, take note of what happens. It's just basically averaging the pitch trace and it's kind of snapping it to where it belongs in terms of a chromatic grid. Before we do that though, let's switch to our separate tool and let's separate this note because that looks like it belongs somewhere else. So we'll switch back to this and make a selection and now let's just use the correction amount. Let's slide this to 100%. Now another useful feature is that if you highlight across all of these pitch blocks and you use the forward slash key, we can addition the changes.
On the PC.
Okay, so far I'm just kind of tuning by eye and everything looks to be working out pretty good, but let's kind of go through some of these over here and maybe listen to some things in context with the actual DAW. So I'm going to use some really quick options to double click. If I feel like I need to adjust the drift, I'm just snapping these to 100%. This one, I believe we use the center notes tool and let's see what's happening this. Let's use the separate notes tool. We'll switch this into two different notes. We'll just double click to snap this to center. And let's addition now from here.
On the way back from the beach to your crib, it's a good day.
Okay, this area over here, when you have these different pitch blocks and they're separated, if you want to see them as kind of like one continuous pitch block, we can highlight, we have the option to join these selected pitch blocks, and now these can be treated as one. So I can use my drift, I can adjust the amplitude, I can use the correction amount in terms of the macro controls, and let's listen now.
Good day.
And then, of course, double-clicking to snap any of these pitches to the nearest pitch center. Let's keep listening.
Guess I'm a little wealthy.
Okay, in terms of what we're working with here, of course, we can double-click to snap these to a pitch center. Let's have a listen.
Guess I'm a little wealthy.
Maybe we'll adjust the drift on this so it's a little bit more centered and the correction slider to bring it down.
You're laughing at my rosy.
Okay, and let's take a listen. Okay, I like what that's doing there, but maybe what we'll do is we'll switch to the center notes tool and we'll make a highlighted selection across these. And I just want to make sure that I'm tuning these to 100%. And we'll do the same thing here. Again, just 100% on the center notes tool. We'll go back to our main selector tool and we'll just double click. I'll probably separate this in case that's two different notes. And we'll double click this. Let's take a listen.
Hey, you need me now.
So this one here.
Need me now.
Okay. These ones, again, if I wanted to make them one note, I'm just going to join the selected note, double click.
Now I know what's next. Don't gotta tell me.
Okay. So this is actually pretty good. Maybe we'll split this over here. We'll switch to our main selector tool, a quick double click just to bring these into 100%. And then these ones over here. And then I probably need to separate this last note. And let's take a listen.
Tell me.
Okay. Now, once we're happy with everything, if you want to continue to work, you can just leave this in your session. But if you're working and you want to kind of like render this down, then we have the option to select this. We can choose RePitch, and let's choose the option to render. Now, keep in mind, we left ourselves a backup copy of our original performance on our original playlist. So that is working with pitch correction manually. We can use the selector tool. We can use the center notes tool. We can make separations. We can double click to snap. We can use macro controls. Super useful. I want to take a look at one more approach, though. We're going to right click, and let's choose ARA plugins, and we're going to load an instance of RePitch. This time though, if I hover into the instrumental, if you know the key of the track that you're working with, then you actually have the ability to go to the scales section, and I'm going to choose scales, and let's change this to C, and let's go with our natural minor, and let's add this, and let's save it. Now let's use our navigation controls to kind of zoom this into view. Let's talk about using macros. So we've set the scale. I'm going to now choose a drop-down menu, and we can choose between high-pitch vocal, low-pitch, or normal range. Let's use normal range, and let's snap notes to selected scale. You're going to get a message. You're about to apply new macro processing. This will clear all current editing you want to continue. Let's continue. What's going to happen now is that this whole entire vocal performance has been analyzed based on the song performance and based on the different pitch traces. And then based on the scale that we inputted, everything has been kind of manually tuned. What I like to do with this is quite simply, I will switch to the split tool and then I will make separations anywhere where I see. I will definitely audition it to see if it sounds right, but I'll make some separations. If I see these areas, like over here, I'll make any separation where I think it might need to be made like this so that these are treated as separate notes. Now we can double click from within the editor.
Lights off, get the mood right, about to be a good night. I've been craving you so bad, sun-kissed, addicted.
Okay, so if we see anything that's an issue, we can zoom in to that specific section and then we can make a separation if we think that we need to. So far, it's done pretty good. Maybe we'll make a separation here. And there's two different ways that we can do this again. We can double click from within the editor, or we can make a highlighted range selection and use a forward slash key, but I would actually prefer to listen to this in context of the harmonic elements. Let's play from within the DAW. Okay, here a bit of an issue here. Again, we have the separation tool, kind of snap things into place. Let's play from here. I've been craving you so bad, sun-kissed. A little bit of an issue here. Craving you so bad. Okay, so maybe this.
Ooh, craving you so bad, sun-kissed.
So we're making manual adjustments where we need to. Let's continue listening with the reference. Okay, I actually did a really good job with everything. The only thing I might have to do is let's take a look at fixing this. Again, I'm going to switch over to the split tool and I'm just going to make some separations here. Let's take a listen. I think that we need to move this one and then let's double click to snap this and let's take a listen. We could actually make a highlighted range selection across here and use the forward slash key. Okay, so that sounds good. So now there's two different approaches. One is completely manual, and the other one is if you know the scale that you're working with, just add it in the scale section, run one of these macros, and then switch over to the separation tool. And you're pretty much going to hover between the separation tool and the manual single edit mode and just do some work, use your ears, and get this to the point where it's sounding really, really great. Now, this is good to me. So at this point, I would probably just make the decision to commit this. And I didn't set a new playlist, but in the case where I wanted to commit that, all I would have to do is choose render in Pro Tools. But now, let's take a listen at the final results of our vocals. Picture us rolling, picture us on the PCH. On the way back from the beach to your crib, it's a good day. Guess I'm a little effy. You're laughing at my rosy cheeks, you're saying it. All right, that sounds great to me. And maybe I would, an argument could be made to do a little bit of a separation in some of these areas over here.
Senses up, lights off, lights off.
But using the macros as a starting point and then making some subtle tweaks, a really great way to get started, especially if you're brand new to vocal tuning or if you're a seasoned pro and you just need to get yourself going really, really quickly because you're working on a bunch of different harmony tracks or whatever the case might be. Anyways, hope you enjoyed this video. My name is Marcus Huyskens and we will catch you in the next one. Cheers.